So welcome to the GDS YouTube channel. Thank you for joining us. My name's Lou Valvona. I'm the pre-technical sales engineer here at GDS Instruments, and today we're going to be looking at the EMDCSS in a bit more detail. One of the most important designs and features about this piece of equipment is the overall stiffness of the system. Now, you may hear people refer to things such as system compliance and why that is quite important within your testing. Now, because we're trying to measure such small strains while testing samples within this machine, if the system isn't stiff enough and it starts to bend and flex and twist, we could end up measuring those system compliances within our test results, effectively ruining the results of which we're trying to achieve. The machine we're demonstrating today is a 5 Hz, 5 kN version. GDS also offer the upgrade potential to 5 Hz and 10 kN. The EMDCSS is able to take sample sizes up to a diameter of 100 millimeters. The GDS EMDCSS has 3 load cells that are currently used within the machine. We have 2 on the shear axis and 1 on the axial axis. The shear axis has 2 load cells situated, one here above the top cap and one here on the actual axis itself. Having the load cell situated above the top cap, we are directly measuring the shear load at the top of our specimen. Now, this can be very important during your testing. The closer we are to measuring the shear load on our sample, the better and more accurate results we're going to receive. The axial load is measured in one position, with this load cell just here. You can see the cable coming out the front of it. Again, its placement is very important. It needs to be situated in a position that isn't measuring all of the friction from the linear guides, but isn't too far away or too close to the sample that it's going to affect the results. One of the main benefits of the GDS EMDCSS is its ability to have upgrades applied to it. One of the main features that is able to be upgraded is local strain measurement directly onto the sample. This adds another element of measuring the shear displacement instead of just using the LVDT that's situated on the side of the lower platen. The LVDT is mounted to the lower pedestal using these 2 bolts here and measures directly the difference in displacement between the lower pedestal and the upper top cap. The EMDCSS has been specifically designed to perform direct simple shear tests. However, we are able to upgrade this to perform direct shear by introducing an upgrade kit that fixes directly to the base and the lower platen of the machine, and removing the top cap and the pedestal designed for simple shear testing, and this can then allow you to perform 2 types of tests with one machine. GDS offers 3 different types of discs that can be used within the EMDCSS. We have a pinned version, a raised fin version, and a grooved version. Each of these versions of the porous discs is specifically designed to be used with different types of soil and can be used with a variety of different sample sizes. So you can get the best type of disc for the size of sample that you wish to test. For more information, contact us at sales@gdsinstruments.com, visit our website, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.